When I was 14, my English teacher, Mrs. Rafiq, narrated, "Once upon a time, Devojit, there was a criminal who had stolen. He was sent to the king for his punishment. The king told him he had a choice of two punishments. Either he accepts getting beaten up by an iron rod 10 times, or take what's behind the big, dark, scary, mysterious iron rod." The criminal quickly, like many of us, decided on the iron rod beating. As his cloth was being removed, he turned to the king and asked, "By the way, out of curiosity, what's behind that door?" The king laughed and said, "You know, it's funny. I offer everyone the same choice, and nearly everyone picks the iron rod." The king paused and then answered, "Freedom. But it seems most people are so afraid of the unknown that they immediately take the beating." I was narrated this when I was trembling to go onto the stage and face hundreds of scary faces willing to judge me and my debating skills. I remember how, before I heard this story, my heart was pounding so hard that it could just pop out any moment. The debate competition ended well, by the way. My gold medal is a proof. However, what I remember of that entire evening is not my winning, but the story. The morale, the applause for choosing the unknown, the smiling faces, and the everlasting courage of the I'm sure, like all of us, I'm a byproduct of my thoughts. My thoughts are a byproduct of my company, the people I spend my time with. My company is a byproduct of my values. And my core values are a byproduct of the stories that has left an impression on me over so many years. That's the power of storytelling, guys. Over the years, I learned many secret ingredients, and hereby today, I disclose some of them to you. Number one, know your audience. Always remember whom you're narrating your story to. Eventually, it's the audience that has to feel the impact. Number two, have a great first line. Remember all those great movies that you have absolutely loved, or that famous book that you read and absolutely fell in love with? All of them must have had a great first line in order to hook the audience. Number three, have some stakes. What do you gain? What do you lose? Remember, the audience will also feel that they have some stakes if you have some stakes in the story. Number four, you have to know your story well enough. And only if you know your story well enough, you don't have to refer back to your memory. And therefore, you can actually have fun while narrating the story. Number five, induce a feeling. It could be pity, it could be fear, it could be anger, it could be empathy, it could be catharsis. But a feeling is important. Eventually, all human beings are emotional beings. And a feeling leaves a lasting impression. Number six, introduce the power of contrast. Imagine a world where, remember the Dove commercial? Once upon a time that I just used. All of this is the power of contrast. Takes the audience to that imaginary world where they are open to more and more imagination. They can actually even take the unpredictable. Also remember, how you say something when you are telling a story is much, much, much more important than what you say. I'm going to leave you today with a structure of a story that maybe helps you in future in becoming a great storyteller. Here it goes. Once upon a time, there was dash. Every day, therefore, there was dash. And one fine day, dash happened. Because of that, dash happened. And because of that, dash happened. Until finally one day, dash happened. For you in the comment section, guys, I'm sharing 22 rules by the greatest storytellers of our generation, who have won 13 Academy Awards, 9 Golden Globes, 11 Grammys. Yes, you have guessed it right. It's called the 22 Rules for Storytelling by Pixar. I leave you all today with the hope that you will practice this art each day, every day, to inspire, motivate, and ignite souls around you with great stories. Best wishes.